his biography called The 12 Caesars, the Roman historian Gaius Suetonius Tranquillus described the house of the first Roman emperor with the following words. His first house stood close to the Roman Forum. Later, he moved to the Palatine Hill, to a house that had belonged to Hortensius, even though it was neither bigger nor more elegant than his first house. There, he slept in the same bedroom during winter and summer for more than 40 years. The history of Octavian's residence begins in about 40 BC, when he purchased a house that was spread over several levels on the slope of the hill. The house had been the property of the consul Quintus Hortensius Hortulus. At that time, Octavian was one of the triumvirs, and he chose this house because it was near the sites connected to the myth of Rome's foundation. It wasn't long before Octavian commissioned decorative works to beautify his new residence, which was divided into separate areas. The private rooms, which lie behind you, occupied the western section of the house. The rooms for official public functions, meanwhile, overlooked two sides of a large portico, which was set in a central position. Reception hall was located at the center of the north side, and it had two adjacent rooms with antechambers. The two large rooms at the sides were libraries with covered recesses. Overlooking the east side of the portico, there was the oecus. This was a large living room whose name derives from a Greek word meaning house. On one side, the oecus communicated with a smaller room, the so-called cubicle or cubiculum. And on the other side, it connected to a large room with a ramp leading to an upper floor of the house. Sometime later, Octavian made plans to expand his residence. Had a second symmetrical courtyard built, which doubled and duplicated the original layout. However, this planned expansion was never completed. In fact, after his victory in the Civil War, in 36 BC, Octavian decided to build a vast palatial complex. And Victory, which were also located near the house, he wanted to erect a temple dedicated to Apollo, who was the patron god of Octavian's triumph and a personification of moderation and order. The historians tell us, upon his victorious return to Rome, Caesar, Octavian, declared that he would set apart for public use many of the houses that he had bought, with the intention of extending his residence. He also promised to build a temple of Apollo, which he constructed with rare generosity. To build the mighty foundations for the temple of Apollo, all the rooms of the house, lying between the two porticos on the lower level, were buried underground. As a result, they have survived to the present day. The new project included the construction of the temple, as well as a library and a large sacred area dedicated to the god Apollo. This sacred area was surrounded by a portico adorned with Hermes statues of the Danaids, who were the mythological female ancestors of the Greeks. The Temple of Apollo was appropriately placed at the center of the palace sanctuary, which included the new private house of Augustus to the west and the public part of the residence to the east, which was connected to the cult of Vesta, the goddess of the hearth and home. The new residence of Augustus thus assumed the characteristics of a monarch's sacred palace. The buildings of later emperors were subsequently laid on top of the palace until occupying the entire hill. The word palatium became the term commonly used to refer to a palace par excellence. The rooms you are about to